Morning all. Actually, no, it's afternoon, so I got that wrong straight off the bat, didn't I? Anyway, we're going to start with a parcel today. Now, I know there's road lamps, or barricade lamps, if you prefer, in here. And if I remember correctly, I know what they are. These have come from an eBayer I know, totally free of charge, including postage. He hasn't charged for postage. So, let's have a look. Yep, exactly the two lamps he said he'd post. Well packed in there. Right. Let's have a look. This one, I've got a better idea. Let's get them both out of the box. Chuck the box over there. Right. That's better. Let's have a look. This kitchen knife I'm using is about as sharp as a bloody brick. Got a Stanley knife somewhere. Well, actually, I've got two and I can't find either of them. But here we go. Ooh, this one's got a... I'm guessing that's a scaffolding bracket. Is that a... go around a scaffolding pole, and there's something rattling around in it. Mora? Never heard of that name before. There's something rattling around in it. Now, you said the circuit board doesn't work, but I might be able to fix it. Failing that, the circuit board from my Nissan mono lamp will fit in. What have we got? Ooh, what's this? I'm not sure what that is. It looks like something's broken from somewhere. There's the circuit board. The guy said it's this bit that doesn't work. So, looks like it might have a photo cell as well. I'm going to pop this back in if I can. So, yeah. So that's the first one. I can always put the one from my Nissan mono lamp in there. It's the same lamp, I think it's just a different name on it. Feels exactly the same quality as well. And this one. It's a Dorman lamp. There we go. That's the second one of these I've got as well now. BT. The story I have heard with these is that British Telecom special ordered these from Dorman Smith and I then dropped out of it and didn't want them, so they pretty much left Dorman with these. Because to be honest, I've never seen these used on the road. Actually, I've never seen BT use any lamps, to be honest. Plenty of cones and their sort of temporary fold-out barrier things, which I've got a couple of. couple of antique ones. But, yeah, I've never seen BT use any lamps, so. So, thank you very much to the eBayer that sent me these. And, whoops, while we're on the subject of lamps, I'm just going to move that because I can't see my screen. King Cone, a fellow YouTuber that follows my channel and collects traffic cones, put a video up yesterday. Yeah. Solves that problem. Put a video up yesterday with his three latest cones, and in the background he had a barrier post from British Gas that had a, or used to have, a traffic lamp E-type on the top, which he doesn't have. I'm back. So, I'm going to send King Cone this one, because it is a spare. Totally free, no charge. I'm even going to put the proper doorman key with it, because I've got, actually I think I've still got three of those keys, even with that one stuck on the side. I think this has got a photo cell in it, which I've already got. I think I've got one of, I can't remember without going to look at the stickers, because I put stickers on mine. Because on the outside they all look the same, but I think this would actually look the part on top of his barrier post if he can get the old bolt and bracket off. Unfortunately it doesn't have British Gas on it, but they are really, really, really hard to get, so I'll be posting that. I'm not sure what I'm going to be doing for the rest of the day. I've got the Saracen I actually want to bring in here, and let me just turn the camera a bit more. There we go. Yeah, I've got the Saracen I want to bring in and start work on that one. I've got a bike in the bedroom, another shopper, my fourth one. I'm going to, well actually it's almost done. I've just got to pump both tyres up and adjust the headset for the steering. You know where the fork's going at the frame, that needs tightening up a little bit. Rear brake still needs adjusting, but that's fine for now. It's actually cleaned up quite nicely. What I'll do, before I go mobile with this camera, it needs a charge, so I'm going to leave it on charge. Yeah, I'll leave this on charge for a bit. Might have a play around on some games on the PC or something, and come back. I might also just have a quick tinker with this lamp. Might even be fixable. But like I said, if it isn't, it doesn't matter, because I'll just take the guts out of the my mono lamp, which has got a broken catch on the front, rather. There, somewhere. Like I said, and just swap the circuits over. He says, get in there. Here we go. You can get Nissan replicas like this with a red lens on eBay. Why don't you get one of them? At some point. Not quite yet, but I will at some point. Right. I need to go and get things done, really, don't I? Need to get this charged. And this won't charge when it's being ran from external power supply. I found that one out. Oh. And thanks to a fellow YouTuber, fellow brony, Mark Hyder, I've got a new camera coming. He said it'll be posted Monday. So hopefully at some point next week I will have a digital camera again. That'll make life so much easier. Don't get me wrong, I love using this old camera. It's just time consuming to get the footage from here to the PC, which is behind you there. Because if I make a 20 minute video on here, or an hour long video, I've got to rewind the tape and then play the tape back and record it to the computer, which is going to take another hour. So that's 2 hours of the day wasted, you know, just doing that bit. Anyway, I will talk to you later on. Okay, I'm in the bedroom. Here was yesterday's project. So I had one of those meh days yesterday. I just felt meh. I don't know how else to describe it. I wasn't depressed or anything like that. I just felt meh. So I sat and cleaned this puppy up as best I can. I've got some lights loosely bolted to it. I've just got to route the wires and connect power, which I could, if I wanted to, connect to a battery instead of a dynamo. Because these do have on-off switch, so I might do that. If I can find somewhere to mount the battery, or even my rechargeable battery. Yeah. Because I've got a rechargeable 6-volt battery over here. So I could put charge in that. No good, it hasn't dried out. If they rattle, then chuck them, because 9 times out of 10 they're going to be absolutely no good. Let me put that on there. Yeah, it's cleaned up quite nicely. I mean, look at the brake calipers there. There's a bit of pitting on this edge, but other than that, you know, they've the brake calipers themselves are cleaned up. The rack's not perfect, there is a bit of rust. But then again, actually this rack is in actually good condition. It's literally just a bit of rust there, bit of rust there. Some minor pitting in the chrome, but that's still good. The front one's worse. See. That's probably the worst bar out of the lot. You can see the difference there. And so I'm guessing that was exposed, because this had that horrible plastic tray on top of that, so it's probably relatively protected from the elements. The rear brake's still being a bit of a pain, but nope. I've got a twitchy muscle in my arm. That's why the camera was shaking. There we go. Other than that, gears work. I've got air in the tyres, so I can now move that out of my way, because I'm going to start on this. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to make a little bit of room so I can set the tripod up and stick you on that. And I'm going to get the tools out I need, basically get myself organised for once, and I'm going to pull the crank off of this. So be right. Right, I'm organised. That is what we're going to be taking off. I hope. I really do hope. So I've got a few jobs for the tools. Well, I suppose I could be considered a tool, so yeah, this would be a job for the tool. Right. Okay. First, I've got to unbolt this. Hexagon key, for those that want to know. I'll probably replace that as well. Now, this is where I've got to hope that the extractor will screw in. If it doesn't, quiz. Sometimes they don't. But as I've got no intentions of reusing this crank, I would have probably just bashed it off with a hammer. Don't use a hammer if you want to reuse the crank. Whatever you do, don't use a hammer. But if it's a... the actual crank itself has had it, then just feel free to smash it off with a hammer. Because it's obvious you won't reuse it, so... actually coming off relatively easy, I think. There we go. Oh, look at that. That's mud. That's... perhaps taking this off for a number of reasons wasn't a bad idea, because I can now get in here and clean all that down. Better remember to take my extractor back out. I'm just going to throw this. This is going in the scrap pile. No good. Get off. Right. Actually, just so it's out of the way, I'm going to take this off. To give this a clean, I'm going to take that mudguard off. Here we go, and start to give it a bit of a clean, shall we? Some of this filth off. I've got to take the back wheel out anyway to change the tyre and to clean it, so. I'll do all in the inside of this frame when I take the wheel out, which I don't actually think you can see at the minute. I think I got you zoomed in too far. Oops. But, I'll just use a bit of ordinary cleaning spray would work. Somewhere I've got a selection of cranks. I think they're behind me. I will. Just as soon as I found the hexagon key that I want. You know, I swear I saw it on the floor earlier. Is it this one? No, that's a smaller one. That's too big. May have to move the front derailleur up as well. It just depends which one of these cranks I decide to use. Because I've got three. It's just a case of finding one that's going to go on far enough. Take the derailleur off anyway. It's just so full of mud. And for that, I need a 5mm hexagon key. Now these labelled. That's a 6, I think that's a 6 as well. Yep. Big long ones disappeared too. So, pull the cable off. out of the way. I'm going to pull the dryer off. Clean the dryer up and the frame. Put it all back together again. Thankfully the mud's dry, so I can just vacuum all this up. It's not a problem. Come on, you bugger. There we go. Knock that off out of the way. I'm just going to zoom you out for a moment. There we go. That's all the chunks of dirt gone anyway. Right. Let's have a look at the screw settings on this. I think they might be causing part of the issue as well. It certainly is. Right. I'll unscrew one of the adjustment screws. If I can get a screwdriver on here, please. There we go. Just got to unscrew that all the way. Right. I've got another pedal like that somewhere. I think I can get away with that crank. Before I bolt it on though, I've got to get the what's left of the chain guard off. I don't think I've got a spare, unfortunately. Not that will fit that. Right. Screwdriver. Oh yeah. Just let that sort of soak in while I take this bit off. That's a bottle of engine degreaser, by the way. That rear derailleur is so full of crap as well. Just chunks of mud falling off of it. Because he went up the woods with this, and of course this time of year it's muddy. So, but before he swapped it with me, he didn't think to clean it. So I've now got that lovely task. I was going to change that bolt, wasn't I? 2 seconds, because I know exactly where they are. Well, I know where they are, I just don't know what drawer they're in. Yeah, I do. No, I don't. aha! Found them. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. I'll have a couple of these actually, because the one on the other side is a completely different bolt. So I might as well make them match at least. Why wouldn't that go in there? Why will you not screw in? What gives? It won't screw in. Is it the bolt? Could be the bolt. It's the bolt. Okay. Screw this in. Ooh, that is much closer to the frame. This might work. And I've just gone and bolted that on without cleaning the frame first. What an empty. Oh well. I can still get there. That's that done. Got some screws to possibly adjust. Yeah. That should work exactly where it is. Is it in up there? Alrighty then. What I do need to do is just adjust that radiator again. I need to unscrew that one a few turns. That's a bit better. Right, we should be right. Yeah. Might even get away with leaving the other side on, because it's not that much different to this side, to be honest. Right, those two can go back in the cupboard at some point. Right, we're getting somewhere already. We might change the pedals so they match, though. Same design, different pattern on the top here. Anywho. Suppose I need to get that light off, because I don't want that on there. Don't want that mudguard on there. Don't want that tire on there, I suppose. Let's get the mudguard off that way first. Ugh. And yes, to get the mudguard off, you gotta take the seat out. Yeah, take the seat out, then you can get the mudguard off. After locating the correct hexagon key for this job, loosen these two bolts off, which appear to be different, I think. Oh yeah, that's right, they are different, because we lost one. Right, that's that job done. Put this back in. Put it a bit lower for me. Somewhere there. Might stick a quick release seat clamp on this. Got plenty of them in my box, I might as well use some. Right, now, the fun bit. Upside down we go. Down somewhere on the floor, I've got a 15mm wrench. This one might do it. Would it? Yeah. Possibly. Tire off. I've got a set of tires up here. Whew. Working up a sweat already. chain's going to be the most awkward bit to sort. Right, tire levers. Right, instead of bore you all to death, I'll shut down here and I'll come back when I've got the tires. I've got an inner tube, but I don't know if it's punctured, so I'll get these tires done, get the rest of this frame cleaned up while I've got this wheel out, and get this all cleaned up and blah blah blah, and I'll... Right, final update, it's done. Well, aside from some fine tuning, it's done. And I've changed the brake levers and gear shifters. It's now an 8 speed on the back, not a 7, so it's a total of 24 speed. Front gears are working. Front brake is a lot better than it was, but not perfect. Rear one's alright. I'm just trying to think, there was another issue. Oh yeah, the chain is slipping off the jockey wheels on the rear derailleur mech. And I'm not sure why. I've changed the jockey wheel thinking it was that, and it's not. It's still doing it, so it's got to be a chain, but I don't have anything better to put on it. I must remember, I've just got to tighten the little screw up this side of the handlebar grips. Yeah, these are actually these are secured with bolts. There's one on the end here and one on there. So yeah, I found up a very nice set of brake levers. So it's been upgraded. I'm going to change this for a quick release one. Get rid of that light. I don't want that one on there. Could do with a different mud guard. I'm going to keep the front mud flap. It's clean. Tires are holding air. That's good. I could probably take this for a ride if I wanted to. It's just, I don't know if it's because of the chain has got some sticky links in it, but they keep snagging in the derailleur and I keep flicking it in at the friggin' wheel spokes, so every now and again you'll hear this tink 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 as the chain has snagged. So yeah, but you always get a few teething issues when you build something like this, so it's got to iron out a few bugs, as it were. I am actually thinking of, really am considering keeping this one. I do apologise for that, my arse is speaking as well. bought this one back in, because there isn't a lot of room on the landing out the front there, so... That's got to stay in here. I'm going to Mum's tomorrow and I'm going to see if I can rescue the seat post back. She sorted all the rubbish, so I've got to find it. I hope. Because if I can rescue that, I could use that rusty old seat post temporarily until I can find one to fit this. But yeah, other than that, and like I said, the rear brake being an arse on this one, and just route the cables for the wiring, for the lights, I should say. This one's pretty much good as well. I've actually decided I need to sell some. Even if I only got like £10 for them, I need to get some bikes up and sold. Because I just haven't got the room. But this one, I'm going to keep. Definitely keep. I've got a feeling it's just the brake blocks that are being a pain on the back there. Possibly the cable as well, but I can change all that if necessary. That lamp works, and I've put the circuit from my old mono lamp into this one. I've stuck the sticker on as well. I couldn't resist. I had to stick the Nissan sticker on it as well. That's all working now. Decided I didn't need two of those, so I just put the good guts into this one, as that was the good case. I've got the lens, I've kept the lens, I've thrown the body for the old one. Because my old one, the catch was broken. So thanks again for that, buddy. I've got that one, I put a battery in that one, that works. I never actually thought I would ever own two of those, because they don't come up on eBay very often. And actually, to be honest, I haven't looked recently at any road lamps. I actually have looked a couple of times, but never seen anything that tickled my taste buds, as it were. Right, I need to get some food in. So I'm actually getting hungry. I'm going to do the boss's cat tray while dinner is cooking. Hopefully this time I won't burn me friggin' wrist twice. Like I did, was it yesterday? Caught my hand twice. I'm begging your pardon. Let's chuck this up on the shelf where it's meant to be. Stick those few chips from yesterday on there for now. Right. Have to find a bag of chips Monday because I ain't got any. About one, maybe two meals out of this actually. Not quite another meal's worth in there. Shake. Stick your chicken pies in. Without burning your friggin' hand. Job done. That in the refrigerator. And the last one. Right. Lots of shit I keep chucking in the bin because I'm just sick of moving it around. Here we go. Are we zoomed? Oh, we are zoomed all the way out. I was just wondering. Right. Ow. Not hurt. I tried to fix the old circuit, but there, didn't want to play. So I just threw it. I cut the LEDs off and threw the rest, basically. I've got all this lot here. There's an LED light. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 LEDs in there. There's the LED thing for the Nissan lamp. There's the old circuit tree. Go in the bin. Sick and tired of keeping crap that I don't really need. I don't think I need that lens really, but keep that box. I need that. Oh, think you've got food in your dish. I will check. Other than that, I think we're good. So, I've had another productive day at least. But, as I'm going to Mum's tomorrow, I very much doubt I'll get to ride that. Excuse me. Right. That does look good though. That's easy. If I sold it, I could easily get 30 quid for it. I wouldn't push for much more than that, not at the moment, because things are slow. I still got that Trek out front there. I'm surprised no one's snapped it up. I really am surprised. Anyway. Buttered tubes for low weight. That's what it says on the frame. That's what I was reading. So there's a couple of bits. I'm going to put the bag back on. I might as well live on this one. Yeah, I was just thinking, that's all. Right. I don't know if stepdad wants to do the dump runs at the old workshop tomorrow or not. If he does, then he might load the bags into the car to take to the dump if he hasn't already. And he might even do it on the way to pick me up, I don't know. I'm hoping he doesn't. Because I want that seat post. Don't care about what's left of the seat on the end of it, I just want the seat post. If Mum phones me later tonight, I'm going to ask. She probably will to discuss picking up tomorrow and whatnot. Move my bins out of the way. Get this door shut properly to my airing cupboard. If you asked me what I had in this airing cupboard, I couldn't tell you because I ain't got a fucking clue. Towels, I've got towels. Come in, you bastards. Can't be asked to fold them up, I just want to shut the door. There we go. Spotlight up there, and it's still so dark up this corner. Well, hello. A lump hammer. I have absolutely no idea why that is down there either. It's been down there for months. It was just so discreet down there, I kept forgetting about it. Right, so I'm going to clean that tray out and get all this area cleaned up. While dinner's cooking, because that needs to be done. I need the poop scoop. Which is in here somewhere. This is going to be my next task. Blitzing the bathroom. For now, I've got Blitz's smelly tray. So, whoop, thanks for watching. If you like the video, please like, rate, comment and subscribe. Thank you in advance to all those that do, and I will talk to you again very soon. Bye.